Hi, my name is Judy L. Moore, and I'm a freelance editor with Black Wolf Editorial Services. Over the course of a variety of different videos, I've been showing you how to use Scrivener to your full advantage as a writer. Today, I'm going to show you how you can turn your manuscripts into eBooks. What you're looking at the moment is the Scrivener demo file that I created back in episode 2, which was for Jules Verne, The Journey to the Interior of the Earth. This is complete with a preface, and of course our tiered structure. One of the first things that we need to do before we create an ebook is we need to make sure that we have front matters for an ebook. So if I scroll down here, we come to our front matters folder, we have an ebook here. Under the ebook, we have our dedication, and we also have our cover. Now this is a standard cover that they give you for Scrivener projects. You can change that, and we're going to do that right now. So if I add a file, and I'm going to add this from my computer, and I happen to have found a cover that at one point was used as a Jules Verne cover for The Journey to the Interior of the Earth. So we're going to add that one. All right. Move that up, and we are going to compile. I'm going to make sure that we are using our Scrivener demo, and we are going to change this front matters down here from manuscript format to ebook. We're going to select the ebook folder. So that's changed out the title page that we had, and it's now added in our dedication. We're going to compile into an ePub. Now when I switched it to ePub, we had two extra data fields that came up here. We can now specify our cover, and we're going to specify the Jules Verne cover, and I can specify metadata. I can leave it to whatever it's going to be for compile that is default, which in this case I'm going to do. If you remember, we had originally set this to be The Journey to the Interior of the Earth, and we had set this one to be Jules Verne, so everything should be okay. From here, we're going to go compile. And it's going to ask me to save it. Now I'm going to save this straight onto my desktop, and we're going to call it Jules Verne, just so I can find it. And we'll let it save. Now I happen to have on my web browser an EPUB program. So I'm just going to come over here and I'm going to open up my EPUB program, drag that in, and so this will open up my ebook. And there we go. We have our title page. We have some table of contents which the system created for us. And we can continue to scroll. There's our dedication. And here is our story. Now that's an EPUB. EPUB doesn't work if you happen to have a Kindle, but that's okay, because Scrivener has an option for you as well. So we're going to come back to our Scrivener, and we are going to compile a MOBI version. Kindle MOBI is what you can upload straight to the Kindle site, and you can also upload it straight to your Kindles as well, and it will read it. So again, we're going to make sure that we've got the cover set. We have the metadata is the same. And when we went to MOBI, we have this added option that's Kindle Gen. Now this is where you can actually get the information that you need for the Kindle generation program. It will tell you everything that you need to do. If you do not already have it connected into your site, what you need to do is you need to click on this link here, and it will take you to this page. This page will show you all the downloads that you need. You have the Windows, you have a Mac, and you have a Linux version. So if you are working in any of the three versions, you'll be okay. You download the appropriate one. Now I already happen to have it installed on my machine, so I will minimize that for the moment. And what you do is you say change, and you tell the system where you have that exe downloaded to. Nice and simple. So mine's already there, making sure everything else is what we want. We have our dedication installed, and we're going to go compile. And we're going to put that one straight onto my desktop as well, so I can find it. we're going to compile. Okay. Now I'm going to open it. And this doesn't always work straight away because my Kindle app for my computer sometimes gets a little bit hinky. But it looks like it opened first time today. Trying to move this around so we can see what we're doing. Come on. There we go. Okay. So I can move back to the beginning. And there is our title page. And we've got our table of contents, which the system had created. There was our dedication. And here is our story. So creating an ebook using Scrivener is actually really easy. As long as you have everything already set up, the system will do everything for you. I hope you found today's video helpful, and I look forward to seeing you next time.